billahi minash shaitan rajim bismillahir rahmanir rahim today I welcome to all of the biology students to my youtube channel biology with mohammad abid malik now we are going forward to start our lesson is simple microscopy our objectives regarding this topic are so much simple we try to understand about the microscopy as well as some of the important terms relevant to the microscopy and second main objective we try to understand about the light microscope so that are the objectives relevant to today's lesson now we are going forward to start our lesson about microscopy you can imagine about the topic after seeing this picture is relevant to the electron microscope so simply we say that microscopy is relevant to the microscope simply if we are going forward to define microscopy we say that the use of microscope is known as microscopy secondly we try to understand about the invention of microscope the first compound microscope was developed by Zacharias Janssen in Holland in 1595 that's a little bit about the invention of microscope secondly we try to discuss about structure of very first microscope it was a simply tube with lenses at each end and its magnification range from 3x to 9x simply we say that the first microscope that was developed by Zacharias Janssen that have the capacity to enlarge the image 3 times to 9 times now we are going forward towards the important terms in microscopy so first one we try to understand about the magnification and then second one that is the resolving power or resolution so first of all we try to understand about the magnification is the increase in the apparent size of an object secondly we are going forward to discuss about resolving power as well as resolution simply we say that resolution is the measure of clarity of an image or simply in other words we said it is the minimum distance at which two objects can be seen as separate objects if we are going forward to discuss about resolution of human eye so we say that human naked eye can differentiate between two points which are at least 0.1 mm apart so we say that is the at least distance where human eye can differentiate that is the basically resolving power resolution of human eye so we are going forward towards the kinds of microscope there are two kinds according to our syllabus light microscope as well as electron microscope but we have already shared one thing about our today's objective that we will share light microscope in today's lesson but electron microscope will be discussed in next lesson so we are going forward to start about light microscope we try first of all what's a light microscope so simply we say that a light microscope works by passing visible light through a specimen that's about definition of light microscope you can see here different light microscope where we can pass this light from the specimen so we are in this picture we see that mirror is fitted and we can reflect the light through this mirror and pass it through the specimen now secondly we try to understand about the function of lenses as you are well aware there are two lenses in the light microscope one lens produces an enlarged image of the specimen and the second lens magnifies the image and projects it into viewer's eye and so simply we say that second lens also termed as eyepiece and the first lens is termed as objective lens or on the photographic film. Now we are going forward to understand about the microscope. A photograph taken through a microscope is called a micrograph. Now we are going forward to discuss about the magnification of the light microscope. So simply we say that a light microscope can magnify objects only about 1500 times without causing blurriness. Its magnification is 1500x. If we are going forward to discuss about resolution of light microscope, so we say that its resolving power is 0.2 micrometer and 1 micrometer is equal to 1 over 1000 millimeter. In other words, the light microscope cannot resolve, distinguish objects smaller than 0.2 micrometer. It is about the size of the smallest bacterium. So simply we say that by using light microscope, we just see the smallest bacterium, but we cannot separate, we cannot study the different parts of smallest bacterium. So that is little bit about the light microscope. And in the end, I am really thankful to you to listen me, to listen to view my videos, to watch my videos. And I will, in the end, I put a request to you. If you feel that our videos are good, so please subscribe my channel Biology with Muhammad Abid Malik and recommend to your friends. Thank you very much. See you in the next lesson. Take care of you. Allah Hafiz.